shopping at Safeway, and you could be our next big winner.
From modest roots in 1909, it's become the biggest annual event on the Canadian sports calendar. And we are ready for a game 100 years in the making. It's been played in mud, fog, snow, and ice by legends and underdogs with Staples and a 13th man. It's been captured by the Sarnia Imperials and an Edmonton dynasty, and even once taken across the border. TSN proud to present the 100th Grey Cup. Stamps and Argos are set, their third ever meeting. It was Calgary in 71. Toronto in 91. Who wins number 100? Rene Paredes kicks it off. We're underway. And here's the outstanding player in the Canadian Football League in 2012. Chad Owens drilled at the 25-yard line. Ricky Ray in his first Grey Cup appearance in 7 years, a record of 2-1.
Ricky Ray was part of one of the most talked about trades in CFL history back in December and has been on a roll of late, 11 touchdowns, one interception in his last four games. There's your outstanding player of 2012, Chad Owens. And Chad Cackard, if there was an underrated player of the year, he probably would win the award. Had a big game against Montreal in the Eastern Final.
First play of the game, and Ray's going to air it out. He's looking for Andre Dury, and it's picked off. Intercepted by Quincy Butler. So a turnover on the opening play. And Ricky Ray has just thrown his second career Grey Cup interception.
Intended receiver was Andre Dury, who's running that patent corner route, a route for Ricky Ray that he has made a living on. One of the best deep ball passers in the game. This one just well covered as Quincy Butler, who's basically a rookie for the Calgary Stampeders, finishing his first full year, played a couple of games in 2011, comes up with the first big play of this Grey Cup championship.
Stampeders did not have a takeaway last week in the Western Final. They set up in Argo territory with Kevin Glenn. First Grey Cup appearance. Here's the top Canadian, John Cornish, and the Argo defense waiting for him and drop him for a one-yard loss. Armin Ermstead, the top rookie of the Argos, and Marcus Ball on the tackle.
Kevin Glenn is in a role, coming off perhaps his best game of his career a week ago against the BC Lions, over 300 yards passing. John Cornish, a statement year for him. The first time a Canadian has led the league in rushing for 24 years. Maurice Price has been the hottest Calgary Stampeder offensively the last 4 weeks.
So second and 11 from the Toronto 50. And a time count violation, first indication that Calgary has been impacted by the noise.
Time violation, Calgary number 15, 5-yard penalty.
Something they didn't expect. They played in hostile environment at Mosaic Stadium in BC, place to get here.
John Hufnagel mentioned it when he talked to Sarah on the sideline, that this is one of the challenges that his team will have to try and overcome. This crowd is loud.
Second and 16. Chris Jones' defense showing pressure. Here they come. Glenn will set up and take a shot down the right side, intended for the hottest receiver right now in the Canadian Football League, Maurice Price, but Maude Carroll there defensively.
Well, Kevin Glenn has the 2-and-out, but what a team guy he has been throughout the 2012 season. He was brought into Calgary as that insurance policy, and that insurance policy was cashed in week two here in Toronto when Drew Tate was injured. Led his team to a 10-win season, good enough for home field in the playoffs. Sat down in the semifinal, got his team here with a great performance in the final.
Here's Brampton native Rob Maber with the punt that'll bounce outside the numbers and down to Owens. And nowhere to run for Chad Owens as he's dropped at the 12-yard line. A 45-yard kick by Maber.
This holiday at Nissan, we're changing lives. With our partners at Habitat for Humanity Canada, and with every test drive, we're helping to build new houses. Because at Nissan, we believe everyone should be home for the holidays. It's all during the Nissan Gift to You event, with special introductory lease offers on the all-new Sentra, Altima, and Pathfinder. Or finance and take a 3-month payment holiday. Visit nissangift.ca.
A second opinion makes a free, no obligation review of your retirement savings. You're richer than you think. Scotiabank.
Hi, I'm Zoe.
Zoe, show us your game face.
I lost my leg in an accident. Now I'm a safety ambassador. Today I'm learning about football with the Argos. Football's not that tough. It's gonna be like my game. A message from the Rams.
The 100th Grey Cup is brought to you by Wendy's. Wendy's congratulates the CFL on the 100th Grey Cup. And by Rona, proud partner of the CFL and its 8 teams.
So no damage done by the first interception of the game by Ricky Ray. And his first in 108 pass attempts in the Grey Cup.
As the edge and experience, this is his fourth Grey Cup championship.
Start deep in their own zone, and here's Chad Cackert. Straight ahead up to the 18-yard line. Malik Jackson, the tackler. Let's set the Calgary defense for you.
Charleston Hughes led his team and was second in the CFL with 11 sacks on the year. Juwan Simpson will go head-to-head against the guy you just saw run the ball, and Chad Cackert had an ankle a week ago, did not play, gets back in the lineup for this one. He's out of Alabama. Keon Raymond has been their best defensive player throughout the playoffs.
Starting lineup brought to you by Rona, proud partner of the CFL, and its 8 teams. In the flat it goes. There's the initial first down of the game. Jason Barnes has the catch. And Fred Bennett, the corner, with the tackle.
You know, the most important part for both these teams at this point in the game is for them to just settle down. You've got so much adrenaline pumping through your system as you come through those opening gates to be introduced. And it's just about calming down, relaxing a little bit, and get back into just playing straight football.
64 checked in, tight end right.
So up at the 24-yard line, first down. Ricky Ray going to take another shot on the corner route intended for Maurice Mann. And Keon Raymond in stride with the intended target.
Take a look at Ricky Ray in Grey Cups and Grey Cup wins. Two Grey Cup wins, and he joins if he can get the win today. Very impressive list of great football players in this game's history.
Second and 10. Cackert stays in to block over the middle, and the pass incomplete. Trying to make a connection with Chad Owens, and Eric Fraser, the safety, was there.
Steps up and make a nice hit here. Good timing from Eric Fraser. And you know the safety for Calgary, and Eric Fraser is going to spend a lot of attention looking to find out where Chad Owens is going to line up and provide some help there. This time he is in man-to-man against Owens, a matchup that the Argos may look to come back to.
So Noel Prefontaine, one of three Argos on the 2004 Grey Cup team for Toronto, kicking to Larry Taylor. 417 return yards in a game here earlier this year. But the cover team downfield in a hurry, led by Ricky Foley.
Wendy's.
Ooh, snowman down.
Ooh, you okay, Lucas?
Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme. Crisp, seasoned chicken, lots of mozzarella, and a rich Parmesan sauce. Making tastes that make the season. That's Wendy's way.
Now that's better.
This season, get a $10 Toys R Us gift card offer when you purchase a kid's meal.
Whoa. What do you got there?
Berry pomegranate mio.
Berry pomegranate what?
Berry pomegranate mio.
Do I just squirt a little?
Or you can squirt a lot.
Really changes your water.
It changes everything.
You can say that again.
Mio, squirt some.
Road closed?
There's a guy.
Excuse me, Glacier Point?
Follow me! Follow me!
Keep up.
Look, he's right there.
Wow. Crystal Falls?
Follow me!
The all-new Nissan Pathfinder. Nissan, innovation that excites. The 100th Grey Cup is brought to you by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
So second possession of the game for the Stampeders will begin at their 44-yard line. Kevin Glenn ranks 11th all-time on the CFL passing list. The top 10 quarterbacks have all won cups. He looks for his first here tonight.
In his first start, of course, in the Grey Cup, was close in 2007. Didn't get there.
John Pointers will line up as a wide receiver. Larry Taylor in the backfield. He'll take the handoff, and Ricky Foley closes him down.
Look at the Toronto Argonauts on defense. Robert McCune's in the middle. Pure run stopper out of Louisville. He'll go head-to-head against John Cornish, the league's leading rusher. Jordan Younger is the veteran in the secondary and has Grey Cup experience, one of the few that do for the Argos here on this in this lineup. And Marcus Ball, tremendous rookie season, one of the many U.S.-born players who wants to move his family here and make Toronto his permanent home.
Four for Taylor, who comes out, and Marquay McDaniel checks back in. Second and six, a fumble, and Glenn gets back on it. Or does he? It's Argo football. Very much like a play last week in the Eastern Final that the Argos lost, here Ricky Foley comes up with the football.
Kevin Glenn gets caught looking at defensive end Ricky Foley. Check out how he's staring down the defensive end and not concentrating where he should be, which is where the ball should go in the breadbasket of John Cordish. He's a little low on the handoff with his focus on the defensive end, and the first turnover for Calgary of the football game.
Turnovers even. Handoff, Kackert trying to get outside and does. Chad Kackert, deceptive speed, told us earlier in the week he's been clocked at 4.31, and I think that would surprise a lot of people.
He has flown under the radar. A very controversial move in some ways when Scott Milanovich, midway through the season or in the first third of the Canadian Football League season, cut the leading rusher in Corey Boyd and promoted Chad Kackert to the starting lineup. And he hasn't looked back.
Eight for Kackert, who came into the game with more rushing yards than John Cornish in the postseason. And Kackert ahead. Short yardage an issue last week in Montreal, but it looks like the Argos have converted on second and two.
see the strategy changing a little bit here with Scott Milinovich wanting to come out early in those first couple of series and try and push the ball deep, maybe get a big play out of the gate and get this sellout crowd back behind his football team in a bigger way, if that's possible. And now in this third series, he's calming things down a little bit, going back to the run and allowing his offensive line to maybe establish the line of scrimmage.
Slow starters in the postseason, just 3 points in the opening quarter of the Eastern semi and Eastern final combined. 4 receivers come to the wide side. Now Dury stays back in and releases late. There's a pass intended for Barnes, but incomplete.
Chad Owens is going to obviously be one of the number one targets. Wasn't on that play, but he will be throughout this game when you consider the season he had. The league's most outstanding player and record holder. A record-breaking season. Pinball Clemens broke the record in 1997. 3,840 yards. Chad Owens topped that mark in 2012. And in warm-up, wore number 31 as he loosened up to get ready for this game.
Last week, Ricky Ray, 11 for 14 on second down. Second and 10, a pump, time. And now he'll dump it off to Kacker. Flag down, and Keon Raymond will wrestle Chad Kacker to the turf.
One thing the Calgary Stampeders understand defensively is that anyone who's got coverage on Chad Owens is going to have to make sure that they know that they've got help in the middle from Rick Campbell and his defense, but also that they are likely to see the football. Chad Owens on that last play tried a double move and was well covered. Ricky Ray had to dump
Major
it down.
Foul, face mask, Calgary number 96. 15 yards from the end of play. First down.
Defensive tackle to Monte Bolden will extend the drive for the Argos.
Let me just show you the double team that Owens is going to get and the attention that Calgary Stampeders will give him. There's Chad Owens in the slot back position. Malik Jackson going to get underneath him as he tries to run this out and up. You can see there's over the hot top help from the Calgary Stampeders' Brandon Smith.
First down, Argos, Calgary 17 yard line. Back inside, Kacker to hole, and Chad Kacker bulldozing inside the 5. Another Argo first down. 12 yard run for Chad Kacker.
Penalty keeps the drive alive, and now the offensive line gets good push, led by Tony Washington at left tackle. He gets up on Juwan Simpson, opens up a big bubble and running room for Chad Kackert. Here's the penalty from DeMonte Bolden on the face mask. Ricky Ray didn't get to go the way he wanted to Owens, dumps it down to Chad Kackert.
64 is eligible.
Monte Bolden got his hands up in the grill.
Andrew Jones in a tight end, and they'll swing it to the near side. Chad Owens, a man to beat. He does. Touchdown. The most outstanding player, 2012, strikes first in the 100th Grey Cup game.
Play they've run all year. Try to get Chad Owens in space. Play action to the running back, Chad Kackert, up the middle. Get Chad Owens out in the flat in space and allow him to do what he does best, make people miss in the open field.
Unstoppable last week, 11 catches, 207 yards, and a touchdown to the Grey Cup for Chad Owens. And the Argos cash in after the fumble. Waters adds the extra point. Homeside on top by a touchdown, and full scrap going on the convert.
Wouldn't it be cool if we took the already great Sentra apart and completely reimagined it with best-in-class combined fuel economy? If it had front and rear LED lamps and a technology suite with Bluetooth, navigation, and other handy stuff. Yeah, that would be cool. Introducing the all-new Nissan Sentra. It's our most innovative Sentra ever. Nissan, innovation that excites.
So, you You think you have what it takes to be a poker champion like me? If you're thinking yes, then log on to PokerStars.net and find the Jerry D PCA tournaments. You can play for free and for a chance to win a seat at the PokerStars Caribbean Adventure in Nassau, Bahamas with me. You can win your share of the millions in tournament dollars and maybe be the next big name in poker, like I am. I'm a big name in poker. Now, Jerry Negreanu Duhamel. Oh, visit PokerStars.net now.
At Bell, it's the Black Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday sales event. Save big on great superphones, November 23rd to 26th.
People often ask me,
do you know where curds come from?
No, where does curd come from?
Comes from air.
Old Spice Danger Zone.
Six-play drive for the Argos after the fumble recovery, 44 yards, and a five-yard touchdown pass to Chad Owens.
Well, there's rubs, there's picks, and then there's takeouts. Chad Owens is going to run the flat route, but watch his teammate, Dontrell Inman, come down inside and annihilate Keon Raymond as he's trying to get out there to cover Chad Owens. Straight pick, not picked up by the official. Owens gets outside and is in the end zone.
Stampeders did not trail last week in the Western Final. Wire-to-wire winners. Down by a touchdown here, midway through the opening quarter. You mentioned Keon Raymond. He's back with Larry Taylor. And it is Taylor from his 11. And Taylor's explosive. Good return up to the 40-yard line. Pacino Horn with the tackle.
You know, for the last 4 years, we've known how good Chad Owens is as a returner. This year, we found out how good he can be as a receiver. Led the CFL in receiving yards. This a flat route outside, taking advantage of that pick, but had over 1,300 yards receiving on the season.
You know, that last fumble by Calgary, very similar to the play Kevin Glenn broke his arm 5 years ago that kept him out of the 2007 Grey Cup bid. Once again, nothing doing for John Cornish. Majiro Kowali and company drive him back.
Chris Jones' defense has been talked about all week long. In fact, most of the Calgary Stampeder offensive players were saying, if you can figure out a way to beat Chris Jones' defense, you're really doing something. And clearly, they are geared up tonight to make sure they know when number nine has the football and get in those gaps. And that'll be led this time by Ajiro Kowali. But look for Robert McCune to be real close to him all night long.
They found a way to shut down John Cornish in the regular season, 43 and 39 yard gains. Second down, Larry Taylor takes the hitch. Got a good pile, and now it's a foot race. Larry Taylor, and he'll run out of real estate down inside the Argo 28 yard line. That's a 42 yard play for Larry Taylor.
Could just tell by the design of this play that it was going to go for big yards because there was no one inside when Larry Taylor ends up picking up this quick slant. You take a look underneath here, he picks up this hitch, one block up on top by Jabari Arthur on the corner, Ahmad Carroll, and he's gone.
Biggest play from scrimmage for Taylor this season. Initial first down for the Stampeders. Bryce in motion to the wide side corner, straight ahead. And again, limited production for John Cornish, who said if the Argos shut him down in this game, it would mean that Calgary would be destroying the Argo defense through the air.
Very good. Obviously, he's got a lot of confidence in his teammates and in Kevin Glenn and the way that he has played, especially that game ago in the Western Final against the BC Lions, leading rusher in the CFL. First Canadian to do it in 24 years.
Three carries for Cornish, 2 yards. He's been charged with the fumble. And it's second and eight. Back in his hands, and again, not enough.
the initial contact once again.
You never know who may step up and be a difference maker. Sometimes it's not the guys you expect that have had the big regular seasons. Sometimes it's a guy that flies under the radar. Gerald Kowale's made a couple of big plays on John Cornish early in this football game, coming down inside. Gutsy calling second and long to go with the run play. Kowale shuts the door with the help of Robert McCune.
He's a guy that Scott Milanovich uses to fire up the team after he's finished in the pregame. Here's Rene Paredes. What a brilliant season, over 90% from 30 yards out. And he doesn't miss. Paredes gets the Stampeders on the board. On this night, we'll salute the icons of Grey Cups past. In the 50s, that included the great Jackie Parker and Normie Kwong, leading Edmonton to three straight cups. And Bud Grant engineered the Bombers' great era.
Road closed?
There's a guy. Excuse me, Glacier Point?
Follow me! Follow me!
Keep up, keep up, keep up.
Look, he's right there!
Follow me!
Wow. Crystal Falls?
Follow me!
The all-new Nissan Pathfinder. Nissan, innovation that excites.
Some people say I'm stuck in the past, but I'm just keeping the good times rolling. All I know is, when you want things to last, you gotta maintain.
Hey, Jerry!
So why don't you turn me loose? Turn me loose!
Keep that new car feeling longer with top-to-bottom maintenance from Mr. Lou. Plus, hurry in for an oil change by December 2nd, and you'll get a pair of Michelin wiper blades free. Mr. Lou, take good care.
Last year, at Intact Insurance, we helped thousands of Canadians restore their damaged homes. But what really matters to us is helping people like Stephanie, who can now get back to her normal rhythm of life. Enjoy your home, Stephanie. You're back. Your home, your auto, your business. Ask your broker about Intact Insurance Company. Intact Insurance, you're back.
Well, it's been a huge week for football in Toronto and a distinct local flavor to this Argo team. With more, let's go to the sidelines. Farhan Lalji.
Chris, after his earlier fumble recovery, Ricky Foley jumped on top of the Argos bench and yelled at the crowd, "This is my city." He's one of 12 Greater Toronto Area Argos. Eight of those weren't drafted by the team. They wanted to come back home and play at home, and this game was one of the reasons why. Now, Foley, among others, admitted this is the first time they've had a real home field advantage with a large crowd. Maintaining their emotions was going to be a challenge. So far, so good.
Ricky Foley, York product, along with Andre Dury. Squib kick by Paredes, and it's bouncing around. Jeff Johnson, another one of those local products out of York, eats the football at the 30.
Well, we had a great conversation with Andre Dury this week about what Farhan talked about and how important it is to play here. A guy that grew up watching Rocket Ismail's Toronto Argonaut, and of course Pinball Clemens.
Went to Exhibition Stadium, said Rocket was his guy, but as a minor football player, came here and Pinball grabbed his hat, had the whole Argo team sign it. He said after that, I was a Pinball fan, and I think Pinball's got a few of those guys he's swung over to his side. Argo start right at their 30-yard line, back into the hands of Cackard. And he works his way to the 35. Jawan Simpson and Malik Jackson converge there.
Well, Ricky Ray now mixing things up a little bit, getting the calls in from Scott Milanovich, who has a 15-play list to start every football game and then goes from that 15 plays with a little bit of feel as to which ones he's going to call depending on what's happened in the game early on.
Lee side product, Mike Bradwell, checks back into the Argo offense, second and five. Short drop, not available over the middle, and a good catch is made there by Dontrell Ingram, who gets up and now gets tossed out at the 45-yard line, but it's an Argo first down.
Inman, a guy who had a two-touchdown game against Calgary and seemed to be the first of the new receivers to have some chemistry with Ricky Ray.
Yeah, back in game one, three catches for over 100 yards in that one. And Dontrell Inman is on the wide side of the field and really has to make a big adjustment here to get to the football. A little pressure in Ricky Ray's face. He has to throw it around that pressure. Inman comes up with a nice catch.
First down at the 45. Play action fake, and Simpson with pressure got a hit on Ray, who has to throw it away.
Juwan Simpson out of Alabama getting a chance in this game to play in that Grey Cup championship. There was some concern he might not make it because of his ankle injury. He missed the West Final, but look at that scrape to the outside, avoiding the block and secondary contain, forcing Ricky Ray to throw it away.
There goes 4 for 5 on second down. Here comes the heat. Ray steps up. He may take off. Now unloads, and Catherine's got a first down, and he bounces down to the 48-yard line of the Stampeders. 17 for Chad Cackard.
Well, if you're a fan of the Canadian Football League and watch games all year, you know we've talked about Ricky Ray's composure many, many times. He just doesn't seem to be rattled by much of anything. Gets pressure up the middle, looks like he's going to run, but eyes downfield the entire time, dumps it off to Chad Cackard. So it's Cackard that takes the hits and picks up the first.
Tight end left.
Getting plenty of first quarter evidence of why the Argos released Corey Boyd. And here's a fumble, and Andre Dury on the fly sweep stumbled, lost the football, and got it back.
Well, and that's what Farhan was talking about, the fact that these local guys that are living their dream right now in this Grey Cup championship got to just calm down and relax. And a little nerves maybe getting to Andre Dury.
Former running back at York, used in a rushing capacity just to get the ball into his hands a little bit more. Number three among Canadian receivers in the league this year. Second long, Ray Owens underneath. Chad Owens dropped at the 45. Cordero Law is there, and the first decision for Scott Milanovic. And we talked to him yesterday about field goal range. Waters can kick from 52 yards out, but do you want to take the chance with Larry Taylor back if Waters misses?
Well, the dynamic of that decision changes when you consider who's returning for the Calgary Stampeders, and it's Larry Taylor if he misses. So Scott Milanovic at this distance has elected in this case to go with no prefontaine, punt the ball and play field position.
Taylor returned to miss field goal 125 yards against the Argos here earlier this season. Prefontaine for the corner, and it looks like he's hit it, and they'll mark him out just inside the 15.
Drivers like these who demand the most from their tires. And everything we've learned making these tires inspires what we roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven.
I just got a new phone. Amazing. But paying to activate it, even more annoying than my new roommate.
Hello, roomie! You're out of detergent!
Still not as annoying as activation fees.
My name is Kazuo Sato. I dedicate my life to Kubota. We start with the engine and assemble with care and pride, like a father.
Kubota, jam-packed with Japanese engineering.
Some more passionate lovers confess it was love at first sight. But those ready to commit know there was only room in their heart for one true love. Kubota.
First quarter stats are brought to you by Intact Insurance, your home, your auto, your business. Intact Insurance, you're back.
Well, what jumps out at me right away is the fact that the Calgary Stampeders, with the leading rusher in the Canadian Football League, only have 5 yards rushing and only 2 from John Cornish on 5 carries. So clearly that Argo defense geared up to stop Cornish. At least they did in that first quarter.
And that's intriguing because the Argos were not a good run defense this year, except when they played John Cornish in Calgary.
Well, they're fired up. They know that that is the engine that is the power behind this Calgary offense, has been all season long. When John Cornish has played in playoff games, he's only played in 3. All 3, he's been over 100 yards rushing. As I mentioned, just 5 carries for 2 yards in the first quarter.
Noel Prefontaine gets the job done. They mark the ball out at the 10-yard line, so a deep field position start for the Stamps to begin the second quarter. Fake to Cornish. Kevin Glenn now will throw incomplete to Cornish when the first option wasn't available.
Trying to get him out of the backfield now, but they're still going to have to stick with him and be patient on this run game, because when you have a guy who put together this kind of season, John Cornish, Canadian, the best year for a Canadian tailback in the game's history, passing Normie Kwong, a record that lasted for 56 years. By the way, that 1,457 yards, the exact number that John Cornish holds the record at Kansas.
Stampeders with only 1 first down of the game, 2nd and 10. Glenn throwing, and that one is intercepted. Pacino Horned inside the 5, touchdown!
First question is whether or not Pacino Horn got his arms underneath that football. It looks like from that first replay that he certainly did. That's an interception and a touchdown.
The previous play is under review by the command center.
Scoring play, so it will be reviewed, but
it's a touchdown.
Glenn Johnson doesn't waste any time confirming Pacino Horn has a touchdown. Argos with 5 defensive touchdowns during the year, and the first year corner has his first touchdown. Waters adds the extra point. Just like that, it's Toronto by 11.
So you, feet up, game on, face deep in a Baconator.
Yeah, sold.
Living large, my friend.
You've got it all with Wendy's Baconator. Hot and juicy beef and lots of bacon. More of what you really want. That's Wendy's way. Or try new Son of Baconator. Decide how big you want to go.
Now that's better.
At Kia Winterfest, everybody wins. Kia Winterfest is back and bigger than ever. And that means everybody wins $1,000 to $25,000.
Plus, get 0% financing on select Kia models.
Woo! Bill Spokes just retired.
We've asked our kids to keep an eye on them.
You know, to make sure they're keeping busy.
They're in great shape financially. Every month, they're getting a check guaranteed.
It's part of Sun Life's Money for Life.
But the kids still want to help. Our son's even offered to do the driving.
Talk to an advisor about Money for Life from Sun Life Financial. Life's brighter under the sun.
The 100th Grey Cup is brought to you by Wendy's. Wendy's congratulates the CFL on the 100th Grey Cup.
Straight man-to-man defense on this interception from Pacino Horn. Watch the Toronto Argonauts play man-to-man and watch how Pacino Horn is going to gamble here and leave his man when he sees a poor throw from Kevin Glenn. Comes up with his first touchdown in the Canadian Football League on the interception.
Mom was so impressed with Al Pacino's performance in Scarface, she named her son Pacino. And he's so impressed with the movie, he says he watches it every day.
Say hello to his first touchdown.
Yeah. Well, Larry Taylor off and running again. And he'll get forced out by the kicker, Swayze Waters, at the 47-yard line on 37-yard return.
Let's go, get another one, T.
That takes great confidence. Remember, for Pacino Horn, it's his first year in the Canadian Football League. And in the championship game, to have the confidence to drop your man. Leave the guy that is your responsibility because you see
it. Legal block on the return. Calgary number 47. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Akwesi Antoy called on the illegal block, and Calgary's taken more penalty yards in this first half than all of the Western final.
Good for Pacino Horn, though, playing beyond his years of experience to read Kevin Glenn, see the throw that was in behind Nick Lewis, and leave his man make the big play.
Trying to get John Porter scoring. Bouncing around, but unable to turn it north. And that Argo run defense has been stiff so far.
I had a good conversation with that Argo defense about John Cornish, and obviously great respect for what he's accomplished throughout the 2012 season. But they said that to try and control him, try and contain him, like they did pretty well during the regular season, as you mentioned, Chris, you could see the numbers. They got to get to him quickly. Don't let him get that downhill run. He's a slasher with great vision. If they can get to him quickly, make him jam his feet, they've got a chance, and they've been doing that so far.
Got four that time, second and six. Glenn sets up, looking for more play. McDaniel almost intercepted. Up in the air went the safety, Jordan Younger, the veteran in that group, and unable to hang on.
Well, most playoff experience has played in a great cup, and Jordan Younger covers a lot of territory. Reads Kevin Glenn from the get-go, gets out there, and it's his teammate. Knocks the ball out of his hands there.
So Chad Owens is back. Had a punt return touchdown in the Eastern semi against Edmonton. Good boot by Maver. Backpedaling inside the 15 is Owens. And Chad Owens up to the 24, 56-yard putt. Well, a salute to the 60s when Angelo Mosca terrorized quarterbacks. The little general led the Riders to a Saskatchewan Cup, and Russ Jackson won three as the greatest Canadian ever.
Some to you, and I'm going to the country. Oh, happy as can be.
We buy 84% of our products right here in Canada. Our biggest supplier is our country.
Mid caps.
Large caps.
Small caps.
iShares.
Low cost.
Income.
Dividends.
iShares.
Bonds.
I like bonds.
Emerging markets.
Growth.
Global.
iShares.
iShares. My own ideas.
Transparencies.
Diversification.
iShares.
iShares.
Every investor is unique. That's why there's iShares. 4 out of 5 Canadian investment advisors make iShares their first choice in ETFs. Learn more at iShares.ca.
Yeah, iShares.
iShares by BlackRock.
2.5 minutes into the second quarter. Let's check in with Paul Appelese and the coach's playbook.
Yeah, I've got the best view in the stadium up here for coaches here. Let's take a look at the pick plays that Toronto's executing versus Calgary's man coverage. They've done a great job of it early in the game. Calgary's played a little bit more man than you see. I've highlighted here, that's the tailback out there with the Will linebacker. When you see that, you know you've got man-to-man. And now they're trying to outflank and force the halfback to go over the top and gives enough space so now he can't recover. You throw the ball out in space to Barnes, and now just with a little bit of room, he gets enough for a first down. And that's what they have to do versus this man coverage, both teams.
Argos have 14 points off turnovers and have a first down at their 24-yard line. And the play will have to restart. The presentation was taking part at the far end of the field, but with participants still on the field, so wisely play is halted.
Well, interesting, coach, talking about the man concepts that the Calgary Stampeders are running and how Toronto is trying to run some rubs and picks. In fact, we talked about the pick from Dontrell Inman on the Chad Owens touchdown.
Mentioned Ricky Ray in his fourth Grey Cup game in his three previous with Edmonton, all 300-yard-plus passing games. Cackard. And he is formed at the 26.
Now, Calgary fans should understand, too, when you go back to that touchdown from Chad Owens, is we're getting a lot of these picks and rubs, and this Dontrell Inman pick here. If Chad Owens is behind the line of scrimmage, it's considered a screen pass, and you're allowed to block downfield. And upon further review, Owens was behind the line when he caught this football. So you're allowed to make that block. It's not illegal.
Second and 8. Stamps show pressure. Underneath again. Cackard. First down. Chad Cackard was a quick cut of the Calgary Stampeders. Lasted about a week. Suffered a hamstring injury after driving all the way out to Calgary.
Well, the first time these two teams played, he was not the starting tailback. At that point, it was Corey Boyd. He did play in game 2. And had 19 touches, well over 100 yards, has been the key to the Argo offense, and a release valve for Ricky Ray.
When he went to Calgary camp, they had Joffrey Reynolds, they had John Corners, they had a guy by the name of Jesse Lumsden. They fake the swing pass, come the other way, and not much there. Pass ruled incomplete, intended for Mike Bradwell.
First year in the Canadian Football League for Ricky Ray was 2002, but week 4 of that season, he took over for a guy who is down there on that sideline right now. The assistant coach is Jason Moss and led the Edmonton Eskimos to a Grey Cup that year. They didn't win it that year, but he's won 2.
First time he's had an opponent in the Grey Cup game other than Montreal. 2 out of 3 against Anthony Calabio and the LOX. He gets away from the pressure and bends downfield. Jason Barnes. All the way down to the 12. A touchdown saving tackle from Eric Fraser.
Fraser off the edge, Chris, and Ricky Ray's composure. Watch how he steps up, feels the pressure, and avoids giving up the sack. Coming from the right of your screen, he steps up to avoid pressure from the outside, and you got a wide open receiver in Jason Barnes down the middle. Brandon Smith was coming from the halfback blitz. Had a clean shot on Ray. And because Ray bought extra time, it was allowing Jason Barnes to open himself up down the middle of the field.
62 yards. A former Eskimo connection. Ray to Barnes and a couple of Stampeders injured on the play at opposite ends of the field. Demonte Bolden and Fred Bennett, or check that, Quincy Butler shaken up and he'll hobble off. So one defensive back and defensive tackle Bolden. And while they make their way to the sidelines, we'll step out.
Energizer Max batteries are designed to hold power for up to 10 years. With the help of PowerSeal technology, you'll always have power when you need it most. That's positive energy.
We built the Toyota Tundra like you would. You wouldn't give it just any old V8. Yours would have a crankshaft strong enough to take on the heaviest jobs. And you'd make sure your truck's got brakes you can trust. Bigger than any other half ton. Now that's real stopping power. The overbuilt Tundra from Toyota.
Canada's Oil Sands is energy at work for all Canadians.
We've been selling equipment in the oil sands for close to a decade now. What we do mostly in the oil sands is control heat. If we can utilize the heat somewhere else rather than wasting it, that's perfect. The oil sands are tremendous for Ontario. It's bringing new opportunities to us. It's bringing a lot of new jobs. They need a lot of different products and services. It's great to be part of it. It means a lot to me when I see the product going to the oil sands. It's just great to be part of a winning team.
Energizer Max batteries are designed to hold power for up to 10 years. With the help of PowerSeal technology, you'll always have power when you need it most. That's positive energy.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Gibson's 100th Grey Cup Commemorative Whiskey. Available now in limited supply at local liquor stores.
Demonte Bolden on the way to the dressing room to get a couple of stitches. Looked like his helmet popped off and he got hit when it wasn't on. And let me show you that blitz again, different angle. If Brandon Smith takes the correct angle on the halfback blitz, he forces Ray to bubble this way. Because he bubbled, he gave Ray an escape lane up into the middle. It's just a difference of a little bit of an angle for Brandon Smith. Turns into a big play for the Argos.
Good play of the drive. Argos in the score zone. Ray on a roll, pressure on. Underneath it goes, and Cackard will step out. And a loss on the play as that was well defended by the Stampeders.
Charleston Hughes steps up and is going to take Chad Cackard for a couple of steps and then come up and finish the hit on Ricky Ray. And you know, in a game of this magnitude, he'll take this hit to make the completion. But Charleston Hughes getting around the football. Calgary Stampeders need a stop right now.
Hughes with 9 quarterback sacks in his final 11 games. Second to Caron Williams. And sacks on the year. Second and long. Ray, Cackard again. Trying to cut back, and he'll be dropped short of a first down at the 9. Juwan Simpson and Charleston Hughes on the scene once again. Man, the Stampeders needed a stop after the big 62-yarder, and they got it.
That's a huge play. That's a huge set of downs. That first and second down there to force a field goal attempt here, or this game slips away.
So Waters sets things up from the 16-yard line. Trevor Harris, the number 3 quarterback, the holder. And Waters puts it through. 14-point lead for the Argos as we head to the sidelines. And Sarah Orleski,
Chris, it was exactly 5 years ago today in this building that Kevin Glenn had his arm in a sling, a broken wrist, playing for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. He wasn't able to participate in the Grey Cup. This is his first time back in the big game since. He spoke all this week about wanting to really take in the moments. He told me that if he was able to bottle what he was going to feel inside the tunnel and sell it, he'd make a lot of money. But Dave Dickinson told me before the game he was concerned about how the emotions and the adrenaline would affect Kevin Glenn, and we've seen the Stampeders offense so far struggle to get going.
Well, he threw a pick six last week in the Western Final and bounced right back. He is resilient, and so have the Stampeders been this year.
Yeah, and he has been the ultimate team guy this year, as we've mentioned. And he has opportunity starting a great cup. That one throw to Nick Lewis behind him, Pacino Horn took it back to the house, but he's bounced back all season long. John Huffnagel said that's one of the things that he's admired most about his backup quarterback, who became the starter in a hurry, in Kevin Glenn, that every time he does make a mistake, he comes back, and he's going to have to do it here.
They had the Lions off balance from the get-go last week with that opening touchdown strike to Marque McDaniel. Spinning their tires so far in this Grey Cup. Larry Taylor's been their most productive. And a return up to the 37-yard line. Kowale with the tackle after a 33-yard return.
Winnipeg Blue Bombers in 2007, as Sarah mentioned, were playing the Toronto Argonauts in the Eastern Final. And it was a fumble on the exchange as Kevin Glenn goes to get the ball. Kevin Iben going for it as well. His arm is broken, and Ryan Dinwiddie would start the Grey Cup game for the Bombers. The Saskatchewan Rough Riders, of course, won it that year in 2007, led by Kerry Joseph.
First down, Kevin Glenn has time. And that pass incomplete, delivered low. Well, it's been a brilliant year for Kevin Glenn. He's probably the most underrated player in the Canadian Football League. And you ask different players why underrated, and Jordan Junker probably had the best answer for us when he said, well, he's not one of those action figure looking quarterbacks, but he gets the job done usually, although this is as slow a start as we've seen from Kevin Glenn this year.
It really has been, and part of the reason for that is the line of scrimmage. Can't establish John Cornisher at second and long, makes it tougher.
Second and 10, here comes the heat, the pass away, and it's complete, and that's a good target to get that offense going. There's Nick Lewis with the catch, a 12-yard pickup, and the leader in second down conversion catches this year in the CFL.
Our Western All-Star, 1,241 yards receiving, and he's in behind, trying to work behind his teammates to try and open himself up for a first down. A little curl route, sits down on it, and that's tough to get your arms around that big body of Nick Lewis.
Last week, one catch, 4 yards for Lewis. Down the rail, and that pass incomplete as they try and hook up with Robbie Bryant, who had touchdowns on similar plays in each of the playoff games. Jahlil Carter, the man on the corner in place of Patrick Watson's, was step for step.
Yeah, Pat Watkins was an all-star, Eastern all-star, and was a basically, a decision as to whether or not he would get on the roster was made a couple of days ago. He's got an ankle injury. Jahlil Carter did play in that Eastern Final and played well and was step for step on that.
Second and 10 from the 50. Out of the backfield, there's the fullback, Rob Cote, and he is going to be about a yard short of the first down, the Cochrane kid. Rob Cote, former Calgary Colt.
Boy, this would be tempting. This would be tempting for John Huffnagel. He's, as you mentioned, Chris, about a yard.
And maybe a little bit more.
Toronto Argonauts dropped into a zone and basically dictated where they wanted the football thrown. That was underneath to Rob Cote. And Chris Jones knows the linebackers will then rally, and it looks like they're bringing Bo Levi Mitchell in and are going to gamble here early on.
Full yard, maybe a little bit more. Matt Walter checks in. Ami Khan, the former Bomber, looking for his first Grey Cup, number 60. In that double tight end formation. Only by Mitchell. Hands it off to Walter. I'm not sure.
I don't think so.
I don't think so. Matt Walter, the former Calgary Dino, is stopped, and Ronald Flemons, the defensive end, on the scene.
Ronald Flemons gets there for the tackle. They'll take a good hard look and bring the sticks in to measure this to make sure. I don't think he got there. The penetration in the middle from Kevin Huntley and from Adrian Obelli forces the bounce. And he's not close.
You surprised Walter and not Cornish? Third turnover of this first half for Calgary.
Matt Walter has been productive when he has been in the football game, but I am a little surprised that the leading rusher didn't carry the football there, maybe trying to break a tendency and use Cornish as a decoy. But again, Kevin Huntley fired off the football there along with Adrian Obelli. That forced Matt Walter to bounce, and when he did, Ronald Flemons was able to get there.
Story of this first half so far, that new blue defense led by Chris Jones. Cackard ahead to Malik Jackson, slows him down at midfield.
Chris Jones, 11 years in the Canadian Football League, six of them. He's been the defensive coordinator in Grey Cup championships. And was a topic of conversation for both teams all week long.
Ray under the gun. Charleston Hughes will bring him down back at the 45-yard line. So Hughes gets home and gives those Calgary fans something to cheer about. First sack of the game for the Calgary D.
And this time, the Calgary defense starts to mix things up a bit. They start Charleston Hughes back where the linebackers line up and then bring him around off the edge. And tough to handle. He's got a great motor.
Boot by Prefontaine. Larry Taylor lost his footing and is brought down at the 24-yard line. Well, we mentioned the first Grey Cup played back in 1909, a plaque at Rosedale Field commemorating that game. And they tell us this is footage of a victory by the U of T varsity team, defeating the Toronto Parkdale Paddlers 26-6 to win the first ever Grey Cup. Modest beginnings. No Grey Cup played between 1916 and 18 because of World War I and an influenza outbreak canceled 1919's game. Pass over the middle, and Nick Lewis wide open, and still going. Away he goes. Jordan Younger will try and tackle him and collars him at the 25. Lewis lost the helmet, but he has just kick-started the Calgary offense 61 yards.
Nick Lewis, throughout the playoffs over the last couple of years, has been in tough. But the last time the Calgary Stampeders played in a Grey Cup game, one they won back in 2008, Nick Lewis had a monster game, over 100 yards on 11 catches there. They get the little bit of momentum back from Charleston Hughes defensively, and then Nick Lewis picks up the ball from there.
Remarkably, he has never had a postseason touchdown. And here's a pass for Bryant, different formation, and Robbie Bryant's down inside the 10-yard line. Jalil Carter the tackle that time.
Robbie Bryant does a nice job of selling that he's going to come in and look like he's going to protect in the passing game. As Bryant's on the outside, watch him try and look like he's going to check, and then he shoots out and gets into the flat in a hurry. This is selling the play, influencing the defense with your movement, and he didn't. Jordan Younger doesn't pick him up coming out of the backfield.
First time into the red zone for the Stampeders. A drive that started at their 24-yard line. And John Huffnagel sees his offense first and goal. Nick Lewis One catch, 4 yards last week, the lowest production in any game of his career. Said it didn't matter. He drew attention away from the guys that did the damage. But it's Lewis that's got them going now. Cornish. And John Cornish battles his way down to the three. Ahmad Carroll there to stop him. And the sidelines are given the 3-minute warning here in the opening half of the 100th Grey Cup game. Argos with a 14-point lead, but the Stampeders are threatening.
The distances aren't getting shorter. With best-in-class fuel economy of 36 miles per gallon, Ram trucks are engineered to go farther. The all-new 2013 Ram 1500. At 36 miles per gallon, that's best in class, period. The all-new Ram. Guts, glory, Ram.
Wind Mobile knows that like snowflakes, every person is unique. So what do you get when you have 200 million snowflakes? Pretty big snowball. But with 200 million customers around the world, you get 200 million unique opinions, which helps us learn what matters most. Being part of a global company means we can bring Canadians awesome things, like real unlimited plans and no-term contracts. That's the power of Wind.
At Enterprise Rent-A-Car, we keep things pretty simple.
Simply treat our customers the way they should be treated.
That's been our philosophy for more than 55 years.
It's no more complicated than that. It's simple.
Maybe that's why Enterprise is North America's favorite place to rent a car.
It's about treating customers the right way.
Let us show you what that means.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Time show 3 minutes away. The sack tally brought to you by Purolator, tackling hunger across Canada. Check.
This promotion collected over 1 million pounds of food for people who need it most in this country. And this is playoff before Grey Cup performances. Grover Covington leading the way. 1986 with 5 in 1 game. Dave Charleston Hughes got one tonight.
Junior IU's great names on that board. Fly sweep. Robbie Bryan's tackled back at the 10. Big defensive play to Jiro Kowale is having the game of the season for him.
And maybe his best game as a Toronto Argonaut in his third year out of LSU. And he's been all over John Cornish, and this time just pure speed as Romby Bryant, one of the fastest receivers in the league, often will get the corner on a defensive lineman, linebacker, and he does it on Kowale.
So Rene Paredes comes in. Bold Levi Mitchell with the pin. And the Stampeders settled for three. Well, we mentioned the first game at Rosedale Field. Then the Grey Cup moved to Varsity. 30 Grey Cups at Varsity Stadium here in Toronto. And then it was on to Exhibition Stadium. We had 12 games there, the last in 1982. And here at Rogers Center, it's the fourth game, 1989, one you will never forget then, nor will fans of the Canadian Football League. 47th game of the 100 Grey Cups played in Toronto. And the home team has the lead. Ricky Ray underneath. Andre Dury shakes off the hit. Great second effort and a first down for the former York Lion.
Well, Andre Dury is now settled down a little bit. Remember that first play? They tried to get the football to him on a little handoff, He stumbled a little bit, probably some nerves, and settles in now as we approach halftime here. Nice gain up the middle.
13 for Dury, first down, 48-yard line. Dury set up as a back, and they'll pinch it back to Prince. And he'll bulldog his way down to the 44. The number on his back for Chad Kackert is the Argo line of scrimmage after an 18-yard run.
There's a little example of that speed you talked about, Chris, as Chad Kackert played his college ball at New Hampshire. And the defenders for the Calgary Stampeders talked at length this week about Chad Kackert and his underrated speed. Watch his cuts and that he keeps that downhill momentum, that speed going down the field, even though he's cutting back and forth, making people miss.
Again, a guy who replaced the leading rusher in the league. Ray sets up, he's got time. And the defensive play made by Brandon Smith to separate Jason Barnes from the football.
Well, that's excellent coverage downfield by the Calgary secondary, because Ricky Ray had time to have a coffee back there, survey the entire field, and couldn't find an open receiver.
Big 62-yard play to Jason Barnes, inflating the Ray numbers. But you're right, that Argo offensive line's giving him time, and it has been maligned at times this year for struggling without Wayne Smith, injured in the final game of the regular season. Again, more time. Kackert, Malik Jackson trying to collar him, but Chad Kackert fighting his way close to another first down.
Again, lots of time for Ricky Ray, and if the Calgary Stampeders can't get more pressure, he's going to start making big plays down the field. Watch this. Pressure picked up. Charleston Hughes in the middle, picked up nicely by Joe Appel. And then Ray slides to his left. All kinds of time. His deep receiver's well covered, so he dumps it down to Chad Kackert to get close to that first down marker. In fact, they do move the chains.
Corey Mace has been shaken up on the play. Well, Kackert has outplayed John Cornish so far. There's Mace. And Chad Kackert already over 100 yards of offense on the night.
Football games, as we've talked about many times, Chris, have often won and lost in the line of scrimmage. And in this game, even though it's a game of this magnitude, a championship, it really doesn't change the fundamentals of football. Right now, that Toronto offensive line is giving Ray tons of time to throw the ball. Now, the Calgary secondary is hanging in there, and they're taking away the deep routes. He hasn't been able to, in this series, go down the field.
Take a look at what happened to defensive tackle Corey Mace.
Chris Van Zyl coming back.
Native of Port Moody, BC, which also happens to be the hometown of one of the greatest defensive tackles in the history of this league, Doug Brown. And Corey Mace's elementary school career counselor was Doug's mom, and talked about her son and his success and helped motivate Corey Mace, who wants to do what another Port Moody Blue has done in the past, except he wants to go one further. Doug Brown never won a Grey Cup game. Devontae Bolden, who was injured earlier, checks back in for Mace. First down. Ray, lots of time. He wants Inman. What a catch. Dontrell Inman at the one, out battling Brandon Smith.
If you give Ricky Ray this much time in the pocket, he is arguably the best deep ball thrower in CFL history, and there have been some great passers in this game. But Ricky Ray put it where only Dontrell Inman, up on that outside shoulder, Brandon Smith would have had to make a miraculous play to get there. Well, you give him time. Now, did he survive contact with the ground? Stayed in bounds.
And the challenge flag from the Argos sideline. They think this is a touchdown, and Do they have a case as he falls backward onto the pylon? Now his backside hits the pylon. Does the football
Toronto was
break the plane?
The ruling on the play that the player was down prior to scoring. They believe it was a touchdown. We'll review the play.
Mentioned earlier, Inman with a 2-touchdown game against Calgary. A first-year receiver who has really made an impact in this Toronto offense.
Well, first of all, that's the ball, as you mentioned, Chris, has got across the plane of the goal line. Dontrell Inman could have physically been in. The question is, was the ball across?
But he does look like he pulls that ball across in the direction of the pylon.
In other words, your foot could be in, your entire body could be in, but if you reach back outside of the goal line and catch it outside, still could be ruled down on the 1 yard line. This is a close one to call.
And again, is there enough evidence to overturn?
Because you're right, he's still up and not down by contact while he's turning the ball towards the goal line.
This might be the best look at. That looks like the ball comes right across the orange pylon.
This may just fall in the category of not enough evidence to overturn it.
Fans watching it in-house, and obviously predominantly Argo fans are anticipating that might be a touchdown.
Take this quick opportunity to say congratulations to all of the organizers of this great cup. It has been outstanding all week long. The festival jam-packed. The stadium could have been sold out twice over. Let's take one more look as they take their time on this ruling.
And this might be the best piece of evidence.
Our 37th camera, 385 feet above field level, gives you another look at it.
And you might say, well, they're going to get the ball on the one anyway, but based on what happened in the Eastern Final last week, it was an adventure short yardage for Scott Milanovic, and he just as soon not have to tempt fate. Stopped three cracks from the one against Montreal. In fact, five plays in short yardage last week without any yardage.
You can also, there's a direct relation between how close a call is and how long they take through the review process, and this one's taking a long time.
Our guys have dug up yet another angle. See if this helps the command center make a decision. Now it looks like the ball comes across the pylon. Is he down?
And out of bounds.
And out of bounds before that crosses the plane.
And by the look on Dontrell Inman's face, he's not sure. He looks at the replay here in the dome. Chad Owens discussing whether or not he's in and what they would rule. And this is the one that the officials want to take another look at before they rule on this crucial play.
Did that right foot hit the white paint before the ball comes across the pylon, or are they going to rule that the ball didn't cross the plane? Glenn Johnson's got a verdict.
After review, the ruling on the field stands.
So if there's any doubt,
they stick to the ruling on the field, and now the Argos will have to prove they're better short yardage than they were a week ago.
And when you're in a game of this magnitude and down on the 1 yard line, it's the longest yard on the field.
And it's interesting to note right away that Ricky Ray remains in the game. This was Jarius Jackson time all season long and last week against the Alouettes. The Jiroquali lines up, puts the fullback in the eye with Kacker. It's Chad Kacker. Not going to get there. Simpson and Jackson, the linebackers, to meet him. And the Argos haven't sorted out their short yardage problems yet.
Well, Juwan Simpson, this is where you ISO in. Down in short yardage on the middle linebacker, number 12, Juwan Simpson. Scrape to the hole, step up in there. Great contact, stands Chad Kackert up and pushes him back so his teammates can rally to it. And that yard just became longer.
Seventh play of the drive. Jarius Jackson is in now. Takes to Kackert, swings it to Woodman, walking. The Argos expand the lead.
Jarius Jackson runs the quarterback sneak in short yardage and has all season long. So the Calgary Stampeders jam up the line of scrimmage. Little play action to Chad Kackert. Gets it out there to Dontrell Inman, and he walks in.
So with 20 seconds remaining, Waters on to add the extra point. And it's an 18-point advantage for the Argos in the late stages of this first half. Seven plays, 75 yards for the Argos. Second offensive touchdown of the evening.
Jarius Jackson, former BC Lion, played his college ball at Notre Dame. Been a backup for a lot of great quarterbacks in BC and is in behind one of the game's best in Ricky Ray here in Toronto. Drops that ball off to Dontrell Inman and he does the rest. But the Calgary Stampeders defensively completely committing to the line of scrimmage.
And a reminder, stay tuned to TSN at halftime. We bring you the Sirius XM Grey Cup halftime show. Gordon Lightfoot, Marianas Trench, Carly Rae Jepsen, and Justin Bieber performing live. We'll also check in with our panel. What a thrill yesterday at the sound check to meet the iconic one, Gordon Lightfoot.
Well, I'll tell you what, that goes down as a highlight in my life because Gordon Lightfoot music has been part of this great country's history for a long, long time, and I'm a big fan.
Waters will bounce it down, and Larry Taylor got to make sure he doesn't cough it up. Well, we've seen the Stampeders in the postseason make a lot happen in a very short period of time, but only 17 seconds for Kevin Glenn to put a better look on this opening half score.
Well, two schools of thought. I mean, John Huffnagel may want to just get out of this half where they are right now, regroup at halftime. It's an extended halftime, so he'll have time to break things down and maybe change up some offensive formation, see if they can't get John Cornish established, or maybe take a shot.
They head it off to John Cornish, and Cornish with a good run up to the 50. Remember the late stages of the Western semifinal first half, and it was a Cornish run that put them into field goal range for what turned out to be extremely valuable points.
Well, now if he's efficient and they're on the line of scrimmage, can get squeezed two plays out here, could get in field goal range.
21-yard run for Cornish, 11 on the clock, so one completion of about 15 to 20 yards, but they're going to stay on the ground. And Robert McHugh, the former Stampeder, will ride him down at the 54, and one more play. little battle between Adriano Belli and the center John Gott. And it was Adriano Belli yesterday in typical fashion came out and he planted a kiss on Gordon Lightfoot, so he's a fan too. Bo Levi Mitchell's come in, so it's Bo Levi Mitchell who's likely going to air it out. Final play. It's a low percentage, but if any team has pulled off the Hail Mary, it's Calgary. He'll set up, sling it long, up for grabs, and incomplete, almost snared there by Jabari Arthur. Well, that was close.
Very close, Chris, and I was wondering if there could be a pass interference call, but there are no flags. Looked like there might have been a little early contact.
Got the feet tangled up, but he went down, and Arthur still feeling the effects of that last play. Let's check in with Farhan Lalji and Scott Milanovic.
Scott, you've had some challenges down at the one-yard line before. How important was it to finish that drive?
Yeah, it was very important, obviously. Gave us some momentum going into halftime.
You guys have been able to shut down John Cornish in the two regular season games. You've done it again here in the first half. What's been the key to slowing him down?
Well, Chris has had some good schemes out there, and our guys are playing hard and understand the importance of not letting him get rolling.
Thanks, Scott.
Thanks a lot.
All right, let's head to the Stamps sideline where Sarah Orleski has John Huffnagle.
Coach, it's the first time in seven games that you've trailed at the half. What is it that Toronto's doing so well to stifle your offense?
Well, we're not getting very good protection on first down. They're doing a good job against our run game. Their linebackers are plugging the holes fast, coming downhill. We got to get completions on first down and be able to manage the game better.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme. Crisp, seasoned chicken, lots of mozzarella, and a rich Parmesan sauce. Making tastes that make the season. That's Wendy's way.
Now that's better.
This season, get a $10 Toys R Us gift card offer when you purchase a kid's meal.
I used to shop around, but now I bring my vehicle to the experts at Goodwrench Service. They get it right the first time, and they get to know me and my vehicle. Plus, they're quicker than you think.
Get ready for winter driving with Goodyear Ultra Grip winter tires. Installed for $99.95 each. Compared to the competition, that's a deal. Visit Goodwrench.ca for more information. Goodwrench Service, expert service at competitive prices. You have our word on it.
Thanks for playing Safeway $1 Million Touchdown to Win. Lucky Safeway shoppers got in the game and won great prizes all season long. If this is your name, congratulations. You are the grand prize winner of a 2013 Nissan Altima 2.5S with the all-new Altima's 182-horsepower 2.5-liter engine. It delivers class-leading fuel efficiency. Nissan, innovation and excitement for everyone. Keep shopping at Safeway, and you could be our next big winner.
Advanced farming systems from Case IH helps producers be ready. Our precision farming solution is less complex and built right into our equipment. Factory integrated with open architecture, AFS works with all of your implements, no matter what color they are. And our team of dedicated specialists are here to keep you rolling 24/7, 365. The world of farming is changing. Will you be ready?
I'm ready.
Canada's Oil Sands is energy at work for all Canadians.
We've been selling equipment in the oil sands for close to a decade now. What we do mostly in the oil sands is control heat. If we can utilize the heat somewhere else rather than wasting it, that's perfect. The oil sands are tremendous for Ontario. It's bringing new opportunities to us. It's bringing a lot of new jobs. They need a lot of different products and services. It's great to be part of it. It means a lot to me when I see the product going to the oil sands. It's just great to be part of a winning team.
Da, 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 da.
sunshine and smile on me.
We buy 84% of our products right here in Canada. Our biggest supplier is our country.
Take me home for the holidays. Don't wanna go our separate ways. Me without you, without me. Take me home to meet your family. We'll see if they're all right with me, with you.
Stay up. Wake up, Canada.
With you.
It's World Junior time.
An explosive half of the Toronto Argonauts in the first half. 14 points off of turnovers, 3 touchdowns total, an 18-point lead over the Calgary Stampeders in the 100th Grey Cup here at the half. Congratulations to Montreal's Era 9. The winning band of the Sirius XM Canada's Rock the Grey Cup contest, as voted by Canadians, to Rock Grey Cup weekend. Congratulations from Sirius XM. Now remember to stay tuned. Halftime show's coming up, brought to you by Sirius XM, featuring Gordon Lightfoot, Mariana's Trench, Carly Rae Jepsen, and Justin Bieber. That is next, right here on TSN.
Guys, I know it's been a rough month, but we're gonna have to work through the night. What the heck's that parrot doing here?
Parrot? What parrot?
Sir, everything all right?
Boss? You don't look so good.
Might have burned out, sir. Maybe you should go home.
Okay. Maybe this can wait till Monday.
Yeah!
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
You can see amazing things, taste fine foods, and meet wonderful people. And if you're fortunate, you can accomplish all of this in one trip. Discover Canada's award-winning Rocky Mountaineer Rail Journey. Book by November 30th and receive up to $1,500 per couple in added value with our early booking bonus. Some conditions apply.
The iconic bottle. The ceramic label. A taste enjoyed since 1925. And the perfect wedge of lime. The perfect wedge of lime. There. Ready to enjoy.
Drivers like these who demand the most from their tires. And everything we've learned making these tires inspires what we roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven.
Road closed?
There's a guy. Excuse me, Glacier Point?
Follow me! Follow me!
Keep up.
Look, he's right there!
Crystal Falls?
Follow me!
The all-new Nissan Pathfinder. Nissan, innovation that excites.
The 100th Grey Cup Halftime Show is brought to you by Sirius XM.
Welcome to the Sirius XM Grey Cup Halftime Show. Now, here's your host, Brian Williams.
Back in September, the Grey Cup boarded a train in Vancouver for an extraordinary journey. This journey visited some 138 Canadian cities and towns, giving thousands of people in our country and a chance to touch and experience their history. You know, folks, we're a big country. We're a country of vast distances, but believe me, national symbols like the Grey Cup and the railroad shrink those distances. Tonight, as we celebrate the Cup C2C tour on the Iron Road, let's kick off the Sirius XM 100th Grey Cup halftime show with one of this country's great songwriters, but he is much more than that. He is a true Canadian icon. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Gordon Lightfoot.
I'm all the time in this fair land and the river did not run. And the wild and dusty mountains stood alone against the sun. Long before the white man and long before the wheel. When the grim dark forest was too silent to be ill. But time has no beginnings and history has no bounds. As travelers spread our country, they came from all around. They sailed upon our waterways and they walked the forest tall. Built the mines, the mills, and the factories for the good of our soul. And then the young man's fancy had turned into the spring. The railroad men were restless for to hear the hammers ring. Miners were overflowing with the visions of their day. Many a fortune lost and won, and many a debt to pay. Oh, they looked in the future, and what did they see? They saw an iron road burning from the sea to the sea, bringing the goods to a younger land, all up from the seaports into their hands. For there was a time in this fair land when the railroad did not come, and the wild majestic mountains stood alone against the sun. Long before the white man and long before the wheel, and the green dark forest was too silent to be real. And the green dark forest was too silent to be real. Too silent to be real.
Gordon Lightfoot is more than a Canadian icon. He is a poet who has captured in words and music something essential about this country. And believe me, he has told Canada's story to the world. He has also paved the way, and countless generations of young performers have followed. We are about to see three here tonight as I look off to the stages on my left. First of all, you will see an up-and-coming West Coast group from British Columbia. That will be followed by a singer who had the number one hit in all of North America last summer. And finally, a young man from Stratford, Ontario. And believe me, if he is not the biggest musical act in the world, he is certainly one of them. Ladies and gentlemen, the Sirius XM 100th
Ladies
anniversary halftime show continues.
Mariana's Trench.
I know.
never make this easy. It's easy, you to disappear. You say give me some. I think that I can go on together. Oh, anywhere but here. Sing it back.
Oh, 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 oh,
oh.
Thank you. see you as a fan. Now you're in my way. Trade my soul for a wish. Pennies and dimes for a kiss. I wasn't looking for this. Now you're in my way. Your stare was holding. Ripped jeans, skin was showing. Hot night, wind was blowing. Where you think you're going, baby? Hey, I just met you.
Let you go. I could take a piss, you ain't never been before. Baby, take a chance, so you'll never ever know. I got money in my hands that I really like to flow. Swag, swag, swag on you. Chillin' by the fire while we eatin' fondue. I don't know about me, but I know about. So say hella to falsetto in 3, 2, swag.
I'd like to be everything you want. Hey girl, let me talk to you. If I was your boyfriend, never let you go. Keep you on my arm, girl. You'll never be alone. And I could be a genuine anything you want. If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go.
What you like, yeah, tell me what you don't. I could be a Buzz Lightyear, fly across the. I don't ever wanna fight. You already know I'ma make it shine bright like you're laying in the snow. Girlfriend, girlfriend, you could be my. You could be my girlfriend until the ever world ends. Make you dance to a spin and a twirling. Boys going crazy on the truck like a whirlwind. Sweaty,
I'd like to be everything you want. Hey girl, let me talk to you. If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go. Keep you on my arm, girl. You'd never be alone. If I could be a gentleman, anything you want. If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go.
Be here at the Grey Cup. and Canada, make some noise. I said, make some noise.
Show you off. Tonight I wanna show you off. What you got? A billion couldn't never buy.
Thank you so much, Canada. The 100th Grey Cup Halftime Show is brought to you by SiriusXM. This SportsCenter update is brought to you by Panasonic Smart Viera TV, where smartness meets stunning picture quality.
And we will get you back to Toronto shortly for the 100th Grey Cup. Brian Mudrick with you. SportsCenter comes your way right after the game. In the meantime, some stories we're following, including the NBA, as the Toronto Raptors, surprise, surprise, busy once again, going down to the wire, needing overtime against the Spurs. Tony Parker getting it done. He had a game-high 32. Spurs get the victory. NFL, Falcons, Bucks, fourth quarter. Michael Turner, busted. He's in. How about the Falcons? They're 10-1 in the season. 24-23 the final there. Broncos and Chiefs third quarter. What a comeback for Peyton Manning. He keeps bringing it. Finds Demaryius Thomas. Nice grab. Broncos take that one. 17-9 the final. And some golf news. Rory McIlroy, five straight birdies. He wins the Dubai World Championship. Enjoy the second half, everybody.
Difference a second opinion makes. A free, no obligation review of your retirement savings. You're richer than you think. Scotiabank.
We're spinning. Wilson, take your hand out of your mouth. That's lunch.
Bravo, bravo. Oh, is that lunch?
You deserve a little, mozzarella, la 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 la.
Wendy's.
Ooh, snowman down.
Ooh, you okay, Lucas?
Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme. Crisp seasoned chicken, lots of mozzarella, and a rich Parmesan sauce. Making tastes that make the season. That's Wendy's way.
Now that's better.
This season, get a $10 Toys R Us gift card offer when you purchase a kid's meal.
You do your thing, leave the rest to us. Ramada Worldwide.
Book now at ramada.ca to get our best rate guaranteed and earn Wyndham Rewards points.
Live at the Half is brought to you by GMC Sierra. We are professional grade.
All right, we'll let the dust settle a little bit in here and get back to football, where it is 24-6 for the Argos over the Stamps. Dave Randolph, Jock Clivey, Matt Dunnigan, Milt Stegall, Chris Schultz. Let's turn our attention to the football game. And you know what? This Chris Jones story has been told by the guys upstairs. Defensive coordinator in Calgary last season. Comes to Toronto in a controversial move. He didn't want to do any interviews all week long. Didn't want to fan the flames. Well, this story is on fire in the first half of this one. What's Calgary's defense doing, Milt? And how does... what is Toronto's defense doing, and what does Calgary do to counter it in the second half?
Well, right now, Chris Jones is doing a great job at disguising what he's doing. He's giving Kevin Glenn and Dave Dickerson a certain pre-snap read, and then when the ball is snapped, the defense totally changes. I even saw one play where Kevin Huntley dropped back in coverage. Right here, you see an interception, and this is the fifth interception for a touchdown by this Toronto Argonaut defense. By five different players. Kevin Glenn, Dave Dickerson has no idea what's going on. In this second half, to combat this defense, I think they need to find a way to get John Cornish the ball. Not running the ball. He's had no success doing that. Getting the ball out of the backfield. I think if they have some success doing this, that'll open up the rest of their offense.
As for Toronto's offense, we could talk about Ricky Ray, but we expected him to be razor sharp in a Grey Cup, and except for an early pick, that's exactly what we've seen. The running backs, Milt touched on it. Chad Kackert is outperforming Cornish. Are you surprised, Matt?
Not at all. I think Chad Kackert is more of a two-way back at this point of his career than John Cornish is right now. Certainly being utilized that way. Ricky Ray has found him in space several times, and then Chad Kackert takes over. He shows you every time out on the football field why he made Corey Boyd expendable, because he makes people miss. And when he needs to, he can lower his shoulder like this. This is Charleston Hughes. Boop. He just plants his foot and he's by him in a heartbeat. He's one of the best defenders in the Canadian Football League, and he made him look silly. They're dominating the line of scrimmage offensively, and they're dominated defensively. That's why Cornish is a non-factor. Doesn't surprise me a bit, Chris, that Chad Kackert once again getting off.
Here's what surprises me about the Toronto Argonauts. They do not have one penalty, not one, in this first half. Significant in that during the regular season, they were penalized for almost 2,000 yards, almost 100 yards a game. This is called professional football. Right now, the Toronto Argonauts are putting that stamp saying professional. Great job in terms of not avoiding those penalties.
That late touchdown by the Argos really hurt Calgary there. So their offense and Kevin Glenn, is Toronto's deep playing that well, or are we seeing Kevin Glenn succumb to the pressure playing in his first Grey Cup, Jock?
No, I think this is just great defense by the Argos. Kevin Glenn had nowhere to go with the football in the first half. You know, remember 2 weeks ago they sat Kevin Glenn down because they wanted Drew Tate because of his ability to move the ball with his legs? I'm guessing that Kevin Glenn wishes he was willing or able to do that in the second half. But, you know, here's the thing about what I see in the first half. They have not been very aggressive with their play calling. Twice they were down in the red zone. They ran the ball twice and settled for field goals. How about at the end of the half? They had an opportunity to have two plays, get in the field goal range. Instead, they ran it and then went for the Hail Mary. This is very atypical of John Huffnagel. I'm not sure why he is being so tentative, and Dave Dickerson with the offensive coordinator. Why are they not allowing Kevin Glenn to throw the ball more often?
You know, through two and a half playoff games now for the Argos, they now have 35 points off of turnovers. They got two touchdowns tonight. As we take you upstairs now to Paul Appelese and open the coach's playbook, one of the touchdowns came off a fumble. Bad exchange between Kevin Glenn and John Cornish. What happened there, Coach?
Yeah, you guys are exactly right. One of the keys to the game is the ability for Toronto to minimize the run of Cornish. Right now, I've got him at 8 carries for 26 yards. Okay, I want to show you the play that the fumble was caused on and how many people they had around the football. At that point, they had so many players. They had seven players at the line of scrimmage with only six blockers. Those six blockers weren't able to make a play. Those six blockers were able to make a play for the extra player. That extra player made an opportunity to come down and knock the ball out. So Kevin felt it, and they couldn't make the play. Certainly what they have to do, they're not going to be able to run the football as much now. They're going to have to throw it up. But every once in a while, they still got to put John Cornish in the mix and be able to make those plays.
You know, they ran John Cornish every single first down they had in the first quarter. Every single time, and he got stuffed. I cannot figure out whether they're not using play action, allowing Kevin Glenn to move in the pocket.
And that is the coach's playbook.
Coach's Playbook is brought to you by Moxie's Classic Grill. Whatever you're in the mood for.
So here are the halftime stats brought to you by Intact Insurance. Your home, your auto, your business. Intact Insurance, you're back. Jocko?
Well, you know what? The Calgary Stampeders were expecting to run the football. They haven't done it with 33 yards. How about Chad Kackert, 101 total yards? He was the big story last week with Chad Owens. He continues to be the big story now. It's effort. Chad Kackert is about effort, and that's why the 101 total yards is a big story here in the first half.
And that's on 14 touches. I expect him to be a busy camper in the second half as well with this dominant lead right now. So expect to see more from Chad Kackert. Now, they've got to mix things up, fellas, simply on first down for the Calgary Stampeders because they are so predictable, and Chris Jones is feasting right now in Dave Dickinson's playbook.
Well, the one stat that wasn't shown right there were turnovers. Right now, the Calgary Stampeders have 3 turnovers. I think their defense is playing well enough to win, but their offense have to stop turning the ball over.
Last word, Schulte.
Guys, my number one observation of this whole game is right now, the Toronto Argonauts are tougher than the Calgary Stampeders. They are out-hitting Calgary. That's why John Cornish is not being successful as a running back.
Well, one positive for the Calgary Stampeders. They had the most wins this season when trailing at the half, but this is the largest deficit that they have faced going into the third quarter, and it just happens to be in the 100th Grey Cup. The Toronto Argonauts have won 4 straight Grey Cup appearances. They're 30 minutes away from winning their 5th on their home field. 24-6, this is the 100th Grey Cup on TSN.
Okay, look. When gas prices jump, you still gotta work. So suddenly you're cutting back on everything from family vacations to cell phone minutes. Well, here's a thought. How about cutting back on gas? Here's how. The Ford F-150. It gets 32 miles per gallon highway. That's the best. So you can get the job done and get a break at the pump. Yeah.
Can you hear me now?
This is the future. This is the Ford F-150.
It's out!
What I can do is protect my family. I find out who this guy is, he's a dead man. I didn't want to go out with you. I'm really glad that I didn't.
That makes 2 of us. No one can know my secret.
A new episode of Arrow at its new time, Wednesday at 7, 10 Central. And watch CTV's Arrow on the go with Bell Mobile TV on Bell Superphone, smartphones, and tablets.
Hot call, Team 1. 911 call. Firearms involved.
Guys, what do we got down there?
Harbor front.
If he starts shooting, his fishing and bear will have no way to stop him.
He's acting erratic. He's reaching for the bag.
What's he got in there, Eddie?
It's a baby.
The situation was a mess. And it was about to get a lot worse.
Whoever has the shot takes the shot.
Drop it!
CTV's Flashpoint. Only 3 episodes left. Thursday at 10, 9 Central.
The Toronto Raptors are on TSN2. Jonas Valanciunas and the boys wrap up November at the ACC.
Jonas Valanciunas, two-handed slam.
Toronto looks to end the month on a winning note.
DeRozan, are you kidding me?
A new era has begun in Phoenix, featuring an ambitious group that competes nightly.
Dragons, cold-blooded three!
With Kyle Lowry back, the Raps aim to scorch the Suns' new additions. Suns, Raptors, Friday at 6:30 on TSN2.
Getting set for the second half of the 100th Grey Cup game. There are the numbers for the quarterbacks through 30 minutes.
The Calgary Stampeders come back in this game. It will be second greatest comeback
in Grey Cup history, the greatest of the 99 games played to this point. It's back in 1981. Ottawa had a 20-0 lead on Edmonton in that game and ended up, the Edmonton Eskimos won 26-23 on a Dave Cutler field goal. Calgary's got a mountain to climb.
Well, you heard John Huffnagel talk about first down production, 117 yards on first down in the opening half, but 61 on one play. Otherwise, they averaged 4 yards per play. It'll have to be better in the second half. They'll get the ball first as Swayze Waters kicks it off. Larry Taylor from his seven. And Taylor starts to run. He's been their best so far, up to the 40. 33-yard kickoff return. And let's see if Dave Dickinson can tip the scales in favor of his side in the second half.
Well, one way he may be able to do that is take a page out of the playbook from Ricky Ray and the Toronto Argonauts in this second half, and on first down go to a little more play action, dump the ball down in space to guys like John Cornish, get him out in the open on those little check down balls to get a little more success on first down.
Cornish takes the direct snap, tries to get outside, and John Cornish with that cut up to the 48-yard line. So good first down production and a 9-yard pickup for number 9.
It's really what that play was, an extended running play to get it outside, get him in some more space, so it's a one-on-one on the outside rather than try and penetrate the middle, which has been pretty good for the Argos on defense.
So second and one. They stay on the ground. They get the first down. And Cornish stuffed at the 50 and push back. Ricky Foley, Marcus Ball. But a first down to open the second half for Calgary.
Throughout the playoffs in the semifinal, Kevin Glenn took advantage of a bust in the coverage in Saskatchewan the last 20 seconds against the BC Lions in the Western Final. Two busts by the secondary for BC turned into 14 points. This Argo defense hasn't given him that opportunity. He's having to grind this game out a little bit and move the chains. He wants to gain some momentum with a few first downs in a row here.
John Gott, the Lethbridge native at center, has been shaken up. And so Abhi Khan will have to come in to take his spot.
I mean, the instincts, Chris, here would be to try and push the ball deep and make up this deficit as quickly as you possibly can. I think that Kevin Glenn's got a guard against doing that right now and just get some ball possession, get some confidence in this offense, take his shots when they're there.
Well, it's a team that didn't generate much in the way of big plays against Toronto during the regular season, but that was pre-Labor Day. But Chris Jones' defense has looked airtight so far. So there's Abhi Khan. Simon Fraser University product now with a shotgun snap. Argos show pressure. Glenn over the middle and Lewis has it jarred away. Marcus Ball on the scene. One 100th Grey Cup on display in Rogers Center up in one of the end zones.
Well, this is the first year that this has happened, and I think it's a good idea to have it on display for people to see it and what these two teams are fighting for in this game tonight. Usually they bring it in with about 3 minutes left in the game.
Second and 10. Glenn under pressure. Foley can't reach him, and Glenn's going to have to hit the dirt. A sack for the Argos back at the 46-yard line.
Again, we see the difference between putting the punt team on the field and the success they had on their first two downs. They get good production on first down with that toss wide to John Cornish, and then converting that becomes that much easier, and a shot to take it downfield. You're in second long now, receivers well covered downfield in that D-line rally.
Credit Ronald Clemens with the sack. Surprisingly, no Argo credited with more than two tackles in the opening half. Rob Baber, not a great kick. But it will bounce out of bounds, and Chad Owens can't get a hand on it. Well, with the 70s, Gardney Henley was the CFL's best two-way player. Montreal quarterback Sonny Wade, a Grey Cup MVP three times. And Dan Kepley was the backbone of an Eskimo dynasty.
All right.
It is so you. Feet up, game on. Face deep in a Baconator.
Yeah, sold.
Living large, my friend.
You've got it all with Wendy's Baconator. Hot and juicy beef and lots of bacon. More of what you really want. That's Wendy's way. Or try new Son of Baconator. Decide how big you want to go.
Now that's better.
It's the holidays, and you should be able to eat what you want when you want, no compromises. Like Kudo. They give you great deals. Plus, they're on Canada's largest 4G network.
You have your cake, and you eat it too.
Oh, El Flabador.
Introducing the new Reebok ZigTech Shark, available exclusively at SportCheck.
Let's flash back to the 92 Grey Cup game here at then Sky Dome. Doug Flutie winning his first of three Grey Cups. Dave Sabundis on the receiving end of that touchdown. Over 500 passing yards in the game. Surprisingly, it wasn't more lopsided, but it was. A special time for Doug Flutie and the Calgary Stampeders. What a pleasure to have the guy voted as the number one player of all time in the Canadian Football League. Great to see you here at such a historic event.
Oh, it's been a fun day for him. I've been running around, running into old friends. I ran into Dave Sapunjis today. We were throwing the ball down on the field before the game and reliving those memories, and it's just been a great time.
Those are good memories.
Fantastic.
Great to see you here, Doug. Hey, I wanted to ask you, though, I've read and heard you say before, I mean, you've had a great NFL career. Great career in football in general. Heard you say how much you loved your time in Canada.
No doubt about it. It put the fun back in football for me. It really did. It turned me loose. I gained my confidence again. The coaches I played for, the guys that I was with, it just freelancing, wheeling and dealing and having fun put it back into football for me.
One of those coaches is a guy that you and I both played for, and he's struggling a little bit right now. He's been diagnosed with cancer, and Don Matthews. Tell me a little bit about playing with Don. We're thinking about you, Don.
We are thinking about you, Don. Don was, he had a knack for just taking all the pressure off you and letting you relax and go play. One of the things he said to me was, look, you're my guy. If you throw five interceptions, you know what? You're going to get a chance to throw six. So that's all I needed to hear, and you turn it loose and you go play for the guy.
Well, there wasn't a lot of pressure in 96 and 97 because you guys rolled to a couple of convincing great. I guess that, well, I shouldn't say that. 96 was an adventure. You even admitted that you might have got the break.
I never had the ball. I never had it. The thing that amazed me wasn't that they blew the whistle, but they gave us the first down, too.
Memories of that 96 game, 97, a decisive victory. Pump from Ricky Ray. He's looking for Inman. And Inman can't make the play, working against Darius Brooks in extremely tight coverage. Up prior to take a look at the snow game at Iverwin. Big play after big play.
Eddie Brown off the foot. Kick it back up and pull. There were some, for the weather, for the snow, there were some just unbelievably athletic plays made in this game.
I want to ask you about the game we're watching here between Calgary and Toronto. Doug, what have you seen so far between both these teams?
Well, the Calgary defense is obviously trying to take Owens away. He's the big play guy. And, you know, you dump it off to your running back. He's caught six balls for 41 yards in the first half. I mean, hey, I'll take that all day. I'm not too proud to dump it off.
Yeah, Chad Kackert had a good first half and been a big pickup for this football team. at least took over about a third of the way through the season for Corey Boyd and the Calgary Stampeders. When you're quarterback in a situation that Kevin Glenn's in right now, Doug, and you've been in this situation many times, you got a big deficit to make up. Is it tough to be patient at this point?
Not for me. That was the key, I think, for me always, was one first down at a time, especially in the beginning of the drive. If you get a couple of first downs, you might take your shot as you cross midfield because they're going to get impatient on defense and wind up coming after you, give up a big play or a possibility for a big play. Just
legal
try
block
to convert.
Calgary, number 47. That penalty's declined. We have a second illegal block on Calgary 33. That'll be a 10-yard penalty from where the ball was caught and a first down.
So penalties piling up for John Huffnagel. It should be noted the Argos without a penalty in the first half. They led the league in penalties in the regular season. So it's a big hole. And you say resist the temptation of getting it all back in.
All you need is 10
plays.
Yards. All you need is 10 yards and you keep the ball and you run two more plays. And every time you run a play, there's a chance a guy will break a tackle and go.
John Cornish hasn't been able to get on track. A short game there. Again, this defense has stuffed him.
Doug, you're part of this new tradition that the Canadian Football League is trying to bring into the season, and that is to bring the Grey Cup to the stadium. That must have been cool.
It was a great experience. And as you walked and as you got closer, the crowd got bigger and bigger throughout. As you got closer to the stadium, it became a little bit of a zoo as we came right up to the entrance of the stadium. But fantastic enthusiasm by all the fans in Toronto.
I know you're working with NBC and I know you're down in Boston, but you know we've claimed you, right?
Absolutely. Hey, I don't mind that at all. I love it up here.
Second and long, and Kevin Glenn now pulls the trigger, finds a target, has a first down. Marquay McDaniel with the catch, his first of the game. Robert McCune, the middle linebacker, on the tackle, but the old Hamilton Ticat target with a key first down for Calgary.
You know, and Kevin Glenn may have to start to do a little bit of this and start to create and extend plays with his legs a little bit to move the pocket and the launch point to make it a little tougher on a Toronto defense that's played pretty solid up to this point.
18-yard pickup at the 28. Calgary first down. Kevin Glenn moves the pocket, looks for Price, incomplete. And they have nullified Maurice Price so far in this game, coming off four consecutive 100-yard games, still looking for his first catch.
Gets it must be nice. You talked about Sapunjis. You talked about some of the people you've seen. I saw you chatting with Matt Dunnigan, and he got a chance before the game to talk to this guy.
Dave Sapunjis and Dave Dickinson,
yeah.
I'll tell you what, we had fun. We were all together. Dave Dickinson and I were together with the San Diego Chargers as well, but Sponge was my go-to. He was my security blanket.
Yeah.
If I didn't like it something upfield, he was running an option route, getting the ball 6 to 8 yards, and he'd do it after the catch.
Man, you look like you could still play, my friend.
I was going to say we could start some rumors here tonight. That pass on the ground to Pacino Horn muffs his opportunity for a second interception. Bo Levi Mitchell with the pass and a penalty marker on the play.
Looked like Evan McCullough was getting a little physical with Marquay McDaniel down the field. I'm wondering if it's going to be illegal contact or pass interference.
Forward pass interference. Toronto number 26. The first down at the point of the foul.
Safety Jordan Younger called.
You know, he's jamming the slot receiver running a corner route. And the one rule as a quarterback, when you're throwing a corner route, see the corner, the outside guy playing wide. He drifted off of his defender, drifted into the pass, and could have intercepted it easily because he saw the ball thrown.
Yeah, they called Jordan Younger, but it was Evan McCullough.
Here's Cornish in space. And John Cornish across midfield. Lost his footing, taken down by Horn at the Argo 49-yard line.
Nick Lewis making a nice block on that play to get John Cornish out of the backfield. He comes from your right of your screen. Outside in, boy, is he ever good at this. Excuse me, he was on the left side of your screen and then turns and gets that McCullough block, stepping back so that he can't catch up to Cornish.
And as you mentioned, Doug, one play at a time, and they've got something going.
That's a great first down call. A little play action, moves the pocket a little bit, easy little dump pass, and picks up good yardage. Safe.
Three first downs on the drive. The pitch to Cornish. And he's got some running room and then gets collared. And the flag comes down. And that'll be a face mask on Robert McCune.
That's what you're talking about. You never know. You can get your receiver, your running back to break a tackle in the open field, turn into a big gain. Maybe you pick up a penalty like this. And next thing you know, you're in scoring distance.
Keep getting first downs. That goal line will bump you in the face.
So after the penalty drought in the first half,
major foul, unnecessary roughness, Toronto number 45. We have 15-yard penalty from the end of the play. First down.
Nickname is the Hammer. See Robert McCune step up on this one, and where he draws the flag. Right there catches the corner of the face mask of John Cornish.
One yards after the penalty, first down inside the 30. Bull Levi Mitchell back at the controls, swings it to McDaniel, and a short tackle by Evan McCullough.
Of course, you know, I would say as a former defensive player, Doug, that I want you to be patient. I want you to put together 14, 15 drives, although playing against you, I knew how many times that happened. But, you know, that's for Chris Jones. That's kind of what he wants to do. Hoping or expecting the offense to make a mistake at some point.
Yeah, I thought that was a good first down call there, yep. Throwing the hit screen, but a great defensive play, shut him down, second and long. So you're right, eventually you're going to come up with that stop play.
Led back in, second and eight. Off the edge, pressure over the middle. Nick Lewis hangs on at the 20, and it will be decision time now.
Right there was the perfect opportunity. We said they'd get impatient on defense. Finally, they did. They came with an all-out blitz. It was man-to-man coverage all over the field. Zero coverage, no safety in the middle. There was your opportunity maybe to hit the home run.
And Jabari Arthur was open down that middle of the field, but Kevin Glenn couldn't find it. And it looked like he had longer than he may have thought he had, because 81 was open deep down the middle right around the goal line.
Doug, really great to see you, especially at this occasion, Grey Cup 100, one of the dominant players in the history of this great game. As Rene Paredes puts it through, our thanks to Doug Flutie.
Thank you, guys. It was a blast.
Hey, thanks, Doug.
Appreciate
really
it.
Appreciate it.
Of our products right here in Canada. Our biggest supplier is our country.
At Enterprise Rent-A-Car, we listen.
In fact, it was an Enterprise employee who came up with the idea of picking you up when you need to rent a car.
Listening. Let us show you what that means.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Earlier today, Angel Magnuson from Port Alberni, BC, was selected as the Scotiabank National Game Changer and was awarded a $100,000 donation for her charity, the Children's Charity of British Columbia, from Scotiabank. Congratulations to Angel on being named Scotiabank's National Game Changer. And our thanks to Scotiabank for their support throughout the season and that terrific program. So Calgary does not gamble. Third and two. They take the points. Trailed by 15. Does that in any way raise an eyebrow with you?
No, not. I think it's still early enough that, and John Hufnagel is experienced enough that he knows that there's a lot of football to yet be played, and He's finally got some momentum from his offense. They got a few first downs. They moved the ball better than they have all game on that last series.
Paredes with the boot. Chad Owens on the return. Kicks it outside. Over the 50, and Paredes will knock him out. Great field position for the Argos. Well, in the 80s, Warren Moon completed the Eskimos' drive for five. Damon Allen returned Edmonton to glory in 87. And look who's there, Glenn Suter, celebrating the most exciting Grey Cup game.
Road closed?
There's a guy. Excuse me.